Okay, so you have almost certainly thought or begun to believe that I had forgotten about this, but I am getting Map Tool all set up. So, Map Tool 1.4.0.5, because open source projects are like that, is the one I'm using right now, and I am going to run Launcher. So you guys, I'll send an email for how to download this. You have to load Java, and I apologize for that because I hate Java, but load Java. Don't let it fool you into making Yahoo your homepage. Just bypass that. And when the install for Map Tool really should be just download the zip file, put everything into a directory, and run the jar file. Once Java is installed, but we'll see. Launch Map Tool. Okay, so we're launching Map Tool. It shows up on the other window, but I'm just dragging it over. Now, I'm going to run two versions here, and I'm going to show you how this is going to work for us. So, this is my DM view. First thing I do is load up a campaign. Here's my test campaign. Actually, it's already set to the right window. I can go and choose the map I want, right? Underground Encounter, right? Pretend you didn't see that. And I can select other maps, but I'm just going to use this test map. You can see I've already got some stuff going on here that I'll explain in a second. But so this is running. So here we go. Now, I'm going to run a second version of Map Tool. It's up on the second window. Launch Map Tool. So now I've got two versions running. And this is going to emulate you guys connecting to my server. So here's me on my server. And I am going to start server. Here we go. We called Einarsson, so that's fine. I'm going to be the game master. Fine. So I'm running Einarsson now. I'm going to change my map back to my test map here. You can see that all of the visibility stuff sort of reset when I started the server. When we're running it over the internet, I either going to use an IP address or RPGNet. So I'm not sure how it's going to work yet, but I will let you know. So over on the client here, we basically say, okay, I am going to connect to a server. And you can see rptools.net, you can have servers running. That's probably what I'm going to do because that's going to be the easiest for you guys. I'm on my own local machine, so I'm just going to use LAN. So now I connect. So here I am. I'm looking at nothing, right? I got nothing going on. So there you go. I've got my chat window open. I've got my connections window open only to show that the game master and random player are running. You know what? I'm pretty sure I'm going to disconnect. Reconnect. I'm going to connect as, Devdra. So if I connect as Devdra, oh, fiddlesticks. If I connect as Devdra, then in theory, see, Devdra the player. But it's blank, 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 blank. Now, I'm going to jump over to here. In fact, I'm going to jump over to my cheat sheet. Control E to force all players to the current map. So here I go. So I press Control E on this view. Now I still can't see, fuck all. So I've done this. Now, basically, if I choose, I've got Lord Stubby and Herald. So if I choose Lord Stubby and I go Control I, I'm not sure what that means. That sets the visibility to what can Lord Stubby can see, right? Lord Stubby has a light source that's 30 feet. This is longer than 30 feet, but I have light sources available. Here, let's take a look at my cheat sheet again. Oh, so here's, as soon as I did that, you can see that as the player, I now see Lord Stubby is selected and I can see what Lord Stubby sees. Now, actually, you know what, before I get to the light sources, I'll just do this. So these little yellow things here are light sources, but so you can see I was able to like select Lord Stubby. If I select Herald, it goes to hell, because currently the view is on Lord Stubby. I'm gonna just jump over here. I'm gonna do Herald, Control I. So now we've got Herald. So I've got Lord Stubby and Herald. And sure enough, as a player, I can now select both of those, right? And you can see they show different views of the dungeon based on what they can currently see. So Lord Stubby, I've selected him. In theory, I could lock this down, but you know, trust goes a long ways. Basically, I'm gonna move Lord Stubby. I'm using the arrow keys and the space bar. So arrow key, space bar, up. See, I can't go up. I'm pressing the up button right now, but I can't go. So I'm gonna press D for drop. And the reason I couldn't go up there is I couldn't see. So this is in player view. This is locked, so that I can't just sort of go into the dark areas, right? I can't just bypass the walls of the dungeon and go to where I'm not supposed to go. So that's, you know, a little bit aggravating in that I can't move past where I can see. However, it's good in that I can't jump into areas that I shouldn't be able to see. And you can see that, you know, how much I'm seeing is changing as I move my character. So I go up here, D for drop, and I've got a whole cheat sheet on these I've got a whole cheat sheet on what these keys mean. So that is handy. Of course, I will send that to you. Makes it a lot easier. So you can see Devdra is up here, and you know, I can move around, and Devdra is currently running Lord Stubby. Now, the bright area is what I can see using my light source. The gray area is what I have seen, so I remember it, but there could be somebody standing here and I wouldn't know. So there could be a token standing here, like a goblin. I would not know that until I go here, and there we go. So I'm just gonna zip down here. Now I am going to jump over to my DM view, right? So the Dungeon Master view, obviously I get to see everything. So if this was a real game, you wouldn't see these guys waiting here for you. But what we're gonna do here is I'm going to go to object layer, and let's say that you said that you were gonna open the door. So check it out, I can actually open the door. Now this is hard to see, so I'm gonna do this over here. What I'm doing is messing with the windows, close out the connections because I really don't care. Close the chat windows a little bit. So you can see here, as I move this on the left, it moves on the right. So as I move this as a DM, you guys are going to see it as players. So basically the door's closed, I'm going to open the door. Okay, so I open the door, and maybe you open the door a crack, right, which is where it is right now. And that's why you can only see like these areas. Or maybe I open the door wide, that's fine. And now as a DM, I'm gonna go into the visibility layer here. These blue areas are the visibility blocks. So you can see that, you know, Stubby can only see this much. Herald can see further in. So let's actually just jump over here. See, Herald can see this, all the goodies over here. Lord Stubby can't. But Harold can. And so I've opened that up. Actually, this door is actually fully open, so it's not really a big deal. So here, I'm going to be Lord Stubby. I'm going to go in here. I'm going to drop. Oh my god. So now, all of a sudden, as Lord Stubby, I can see this whole area, right? And the door's open, all that kind of stuff. That's really good. Now, I can see, as Lord Stubby, I can see that this door is open. I can see to the corridor beyond. I can see that this door is open, and I can see in a little bit. I can see whatever this is. That looks pretty interesting. I can see all this goodie stuff, you know, some food hanging around. That may or may not be interesting. I can also see that this room is numbered 11. I don't think I really care about that. As I move down, I'm looking in. Now you can see, I can see in here. Now, what's happening here? Lord Stubby should be able to see these guys. Now, here's the problem. I've got them set to the hidden layer. Here, go to the hidden layer. So, I've got them set to the hidden layer. So, I should have had them on the object layer, or the token layer, but I had them on the hidden layer so that I can like hide things from you guys until needed, and then I can drop them in. So I'm gonna refigure out how to set these to. There we go. Change to token layer. So now these guys are changed to token layer. I'm gonna make sure this guy is on token layer. Change to token layer. So so now I'm on hidden layer. I can't select them anymore, right? So I go to token layer. I'll be able to select them. Yep, there they go. And if I jump back to Devdra as the player, suddenly they've appeared, right? So they would have appeared as soon as I changed them. Now you and I know that there's somebody hiding here, but you know, Lord Stubby slash Devdra doesn't know that. So do do do. Here we go. So you can see Lord Stubby is still. I've got a view block, like a visual block on the door. It's a little bit aggravating because I can't put a visual block on the object, so it can't change as the object moves. I actually literally have to go in and redraw it. But it's better than having you see the goblin behind the door. So here's Lord Stubby coming in, and let's say Lord Stubby decides, you know, fight, fight, fight. They're gonna fight, and there's initiative, and they're rolling things. And Lord Stubby, if Lord Stubby looks over, he or she can see that there's something going on over here. So let's say eventually, state dead. So Lord Stubby kills the two goblins. This goblin, I'm right now in Devdra player mode, so I'm gonna zip over. This goblin, come on. I could have sworn that I'm. I could have sworn that I changed this little fellow to token. Yeah, see, I've got the outline. I'm Dungeon Master. Why can I not change him? I have no idea why I can't change him right now. He's Goblin Blue 15. If Goblin Blue 15 was. See, it says Devdra. That doesn't make any sense to me. There we go. Devdra has clicked on Lord Stubby. Devdra is Lord Stubby. If I jump over here, maybe I can move him now. Yeah, see, Devdra had him locked. So, as a player, don't lock my. My guys, took me off. I'm gonna turn him around a little bit. There we go. And now he's gonna attack. You know, Goblin Blue 15 is gonna attack Lord Stubby. Fight, fight, fight. You know, maybe you're fighting, and you know he's becomes disabled, and then eventually you kill him. Right, so off he goes. Hey. Dead. Oh, I see. They're additive. Okay, well, who knew? Disabled and... Come on, state dead. There we go. As you can see, there's tons of options. Eventually, I'll get better at that, but, you know, for now, whatever. Okay, so there's a crossbow here, but that must be on the hidden layer. Let's take a look. Hidden layer. Nope. Background layer? No? Object layer? Okay, the crossbow is here, but Lord Stubby slash Devdra can't see it. I don't know why. Here, let's take a look. It's a crossbow. It's a non-player character. Okay, fine. Oh, here we go. Visible to players, right? So you can see that I had it there, but I hadn't set it visible to players. Blah. Okay, so fine. So now it's visible to players. Sure enough, Lord Stubby can see it. So, and Lord Stubby is going to take it. Lord Stubby is right on top of the blue goblin, which I'm sure will get aggravating, but it is what it is. You know, I bet. Game Master, come on. Token. So I can cut things, take them out, etc., etc. So anyway, Lord Stubby can take the crossbow. I'll go to object, and then I will get rid of it, and Lord Stubby now has a crossbow. Okay, Lord Stubby, you can turn yourself if you want, but not necessary. Okay, so Lord Stubby's now moved through here. So now Lord Stubby is moving through this area. And you can see that Lord Stubby can see through different areas. Right, so Lord Stubby has come through here. And as Lord Stubby moves along the path, I've got a light source here, which like is right in the door, which doesn't make any sense. But as Lord Stubby moved past here, Lord Stubby was able to see what the room looked like. However, Lord Stubby would not have known if there were objects there, like, you know, enemies or something like that. So it's good to pause in front of doors just to see what's going on. Anyway, so here we go. Doo doo. Lord Stubby's moving around, right? And I really do. I have to say, I really do like the line of sight sort of options on map tool. Now, these doors are here, so Lord Stubby's gonna come up here. So now Lord Stubby's gonna say, "I'm gonna open this door." Actually, you know what? I don't have to do it freeform. I think I can do shift. Yeah, see, shift will move 90 degrees at a time. Control shift will move like small amounts at a time. Anyway, there's a door here, so Lord Stubby is going to open it. Lord Stubby can't actually open the door. Like, this is not a video game. So I can go to the object layer, and then, and remember, it's opening as I do it. However, even though the door is opening, and actually I'm doing it the wrong way, because you can probably see here, the hinge is actually right here. And the nice thing is the map tool actually respects the hinge, like the way it's set up. So the hinge is the pivot point for the object, which is kind of neat. So now the door's open, but because the visual layer is still there, Lord Stubby can't see through. So what we're gonna do is the first thing I do is I draw, and I really hope they fix this soon. So I've drawn a non-visible bar here, and then I'm going to open up this area, right? So now I've opened this up, and Control I, woo! Lord Stubby can now see in there. Look at that, Lord Stubby, go! Who's hiding behind the door? Oh, nobody's hiding behind the door. Okay. So this is going to allow for exploration of known areas quite well. For larger areas, underground caverns, mithril mine, approach road. For other areas, oh, I'm player, so I. Oh, the DM hasn't done anything. For other areas, we can still share maps, right? And so you as the players can look here and say, hey, what's going on? I'm going to be characters, whatever, I don't care. Oh, right, I forgot that I had all these characters on here. As soon as I put a character on, and Devdra was that character, Devdra was able to see what was going on here. This, you don't have to worry about it, this is like stuff that was happening in a previous game. So if I'm DM, I can jump over to Ilea Approach Road. And now you can see that Ilea Approach Road, I've actually got a lot of blue where you can't see. And if I go to view map, Fog of War, there we go. So Fog of War and Vision Day, yep. So now, as character BG305, Devdra can see what's happening in the world, but not through, you know, the solid rock, etc., etc. Now, Devdra, I would have thought Devdra would have been more aligned with the grid, to be honest. There is a grid thing here, so let's zoom in. And oh, I forget what the grid. I can adjust the grid, Control Shift A. But I don't want to adjust the grid, I want to show the grid. Let's take a look at my map related keyboards here. New grid, new map, grid settings, meta shift A, no. I just want show grid, toggle grid on and off, meta G. Okay, G for grid. Well, who knew? Control G. There we go. So now we've got grid. See how it's not lining up very well? Don't like that. Probably because it lined. Actually, you know what? I have no idea. Maybe it lines up on top. I just don't know. Usually I try and line the grids up. So usually on my maps, I have a 10 by 10 grid, and in the game you want a 5 by 5 grid because each character essentially takes up 5 feet, which is ridiculous, but you know, there you have it. So I'm gonna zip over to here, turn on my grid, Control Shift A for adjust grid. First of all, I'm going to make the color like gray, not like freaking super dark black. Then I'm going to grid size. Okay, grid X. Not too bad, really. Let's do a grid Y of 5. Grid Y of 9. Oh, grid Y of 9 is getting close. Grid Y of 10. I'm liking grid Y of 10. Okay. So now you can see that if I'm Devdra, and actually I can Control G. If I'm Devdra, now all of a sudden, right? Now all of a sudden I can move every 5 feet the way I'm supposed to. And it lines up with the actual grid on the map. Now if I draw the maps not on grid paper, and then overlay the grid on top of it, then that's much easier and I don't have to worry about that kind of thing. But when I draw on grid paper, which I do quite often, then I can line it up and make sure that grid works out. Anyway, so what we've got here is basically a daytime scene where line of sight isn't as important, but I can move my character around. Now I can move my character into the building, but that's not useful. And you can see it's not really to scale, right? Because, you know, my character isn't actually half the width of the entire building. But you know what? It's close enough, and certainly good enough for online gaming. I've been talking for 25 minutes straight, and I think this is showing how this can work. Here is the remnants of a battle. These were actually representing ballistae. These guys were enemies. These guys were cleric enemies. I think these guys were the good guys. Torsten. Oh no, Torsten was one of the big enemies. Tortaken and Torsten. Now they moved when I... Oh, am I Devdra? Yeah, I'm Devdra. There we go. So Tortaken and Torsten, they moved when I changed the grid, but that's fine. Normally you don't do that. So, you know, we've got some dwarves, we've got some enemies, they're fighting on the... This is like a path on the cliff. You know, and then the path comes up, and then you head into, like, the mines here, and you've got buildings and shit. You can see that over time, as you're actually rolling your dice and fighting the battle, we can adjust the overlay so that everybody shows the way they're supposed to show. And then as you're playing, like, you know, just like miniature figures, the characters themselves don't matter so much. These were Atawadanai, so, you know, obviously they're flyers. They're not something that the players would necessarily have to identify directly as Elvish Bowmen. As long as you know what they are, and then that's fine. And, you know, if you're in this campaign, then Tortaken and Torsten are very important to you. The dwarves are your friends, but, you know, their individual names aren't as important. So that is how we are going to run this as multiplayer. So each player will have a version of Map Tool running. We'll be able to do this. Oh, you know, to be honest, I really hate this interface where it like takes over part of the screen. Down here, hidden behind my video controls, is actually a chat bar where I can write, you know. I don't think it's going to let me. Yeah, it's not going to. I can just write like notes and stuff. But we're going to use something like Skype, or better yet, Google Hangouts, and that will allow us to video, like, we'll have a video stream of each player at our desks, plus the play map here as a sort of common area. So I think, you know, it should work. It's sort of in the what could possibly go wrong realm. So I am going to be sending you, I've sent you an email linking to this video. I'm going to be sending an email figuring out when we're going to do our first game. And what we're going to do for our first game is not going to be, it's not going to be difficult. What we're going to do is we're going to do like a stupid dungeon thing, just so that we get an idea for how we're going to do this. If I jump over here and I do Control Shift E, does that... Nope, I have to look at my cheat sheet. Control E. Yeah, see? The players did get forced over. So Control E, for whatever reason, forces you over. So Lord Stubby. So I'm going to... I am going to send you guys instructions and... and we can, like, we can do this. We can play this game. Maybe not super quick, but we never were that quick. And we can play this game interactively. See now Lord Stubby can see through here. Oh, I do need to add this though. There we go. So Lord Stubby now, right, can't see past the door until, haha, she looks. Anyway, I digress. So we can set up some games, and I'm just going to assume everybody has their own dice. Now, I'll put this in the video or in the email as well, but I don't expect anyone to really have their character sheets anymore. If you do, that's awesome. If you don't, we'll just make it up. So that's it for now. It's been 30 minutes. If you're still here, congratulations. And I will talk to you guys soon. Bye for now.